Hello, my dear children. How are you all? Hope you all are fine over there. Once again, welcome to our physics class. Children, we have completed our chapter Human Eye and Colorful World with the previous session. Today, we are going to start our new chapter and also the last chapter of class 10 physics, that is sources of energy. You might have studied about the same concept in your social studies. Non-renewable resources, renewable resources, and also the conventional and non-conventional sources of energy. All those concepts you had already studied in your social studies, isn't it? So now in physics, we will just go for a quick review of all those concepts. And most of the schools are having the opinion that this chapter has been deleted completely. But still, there are some topics which is not specified by CBSE. That topic is deleted or not. So I'm not sure about that. So let me just go for a quick review of this chapter. Be relaxed and then listen to this video lesson. So let's get started with today's session, my dear children. So let's begin our new chapter, chapter 14, sources of energy. So what is energy? Energy is the ability to do work. Or it is the total power derived from our natural resources. Energy exists in many forms and can be converted from one form of energy into another. Energy in usable form is dissipated to the surroundings as less usable form. Energy is mainly derived from natural sources like sun, oceans, fossil fuels, wind, etc., and is converted into electrical energy that we consume for our daily needs. Okay, so this is about energy. We know different types of energies are available in our nature, like solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, chemical energy, thermal energy, again energy derived from the water, like that. So all this energy or energy derived from this natural resources like sun, oceans, fossil fuels, wind, etc. is converted into electrical energy. Okay. Source of energy. So what do you mean by a source of energy? A source of energy is that which is capable of providing enough useful energy at a steady rate over a long period of time. Okay, so an energy source must provide enough energy and that energy must be in the useful form. So a source of energy is that which is capable of providing enough useful energy and moreover it should provide that energy at a steady rate without any decrease at a steady rate over a long period of time. Not for a limited period, over a long period of time. Next, what do you mean by a good source of energy? See, a good source of energy should be safe and convenient to use, isn't it? For example, nuclear energy. Nuclear energy can be used only by highly trained engineers with the help of nuclear power plants. It cannot be used for our household purpose. Okay, so it is not safe and convenient to use. Then it should be easy to transport. For example, coal, petrol, diesel, LPG, etc. have to be transported from the places of their production to the consumers. Okay, then a good source of energy must be easy to store. For example, huge storage tanks are required to store petrol, diesel, LPG, etc. So what are the characteristics of a good fuel? Characteristics of a good fuel is that it must have a high calorific value and it must produce less smoke on burning and it must leave less residue after burning and it should be easily available. Okay, it should be cheaper, that means inexpensive, economical, and it should be easy to store and transport. So all these are characteristics of a good fuel. Okay. Classification of sources of energy. And there are different sources of energy. Mainly the energy sources are classified into renewable source and non-renewable source. So renewable source of energy means the energy sources that can be renewed or replenished even after use. Okay. And some examples of renewable sources of energy are this solar energy, wind energy. So even if we use all these energies in a tremendous amount, it is renewed year after year. Solar energy, wind energy, water energy, that means hydro energy, geothermal energy, ocean energy, biomass energy, that is firewood, animal dung and biodegradable waste from cities and crop residues constitute biomass. So these are some of the renewable sources of energy. And what are the advantages of renewable sources of energy? These sources will last as long as the earth receives light from the sun. Okay, that means solar energy. Solar energy will last as long as sun is there. And these sources are freely available in nature. These sources do not cause any pollution. So these are some of the advantages of renewable sources of energy. Then what do you mean by non-renewable source of energy? Non-renewable sources of energy are those which are exhaustible and cannot be replaced once they have been used. So unlike renewable, non-renewable sources of energy are exhaustible and they cannot be replaced once they have been used. And these sources have been accumulated in nature over a long period of millions of years. It took millions of years for their formation. Example, coal, oil, natural gas, all are non-renewable sources of energy. That means fossil fuels are non-renewable sources of energy. Okay, so what are the disadvantages of non-renewable sources of energy? Due to their extensive use, these sources are fast depleting and it is difficult to discover and exploit new deposits of these sources. These sources are a major cause of environmental pollution. Okay, so these are some of the disadvantages, common disadvantages of non-renewable sources of energy. Because we are using it in a tremendous rate, these sources will deplete faster. Okay, and also it is difficult to discover and exploit new deposits of these sources. As you know, it takes millions of years for the formation of this non-renewable sources of energy. So it is very difficult to discover and exploit new deposits of these sources. And also these sources are a major cause of environmental pollution. So children, that's all about the energy sources and the different types of energy sources. So with this, I'm concluding my session. We will meet in the next session. Till then, take care all of you. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.